it is kind of quite isolating in sex work, because it's not something that people feel like that they can really openly talk about. You know, I think there's this misconception it's because that we're ashamed of what we do. My name's Jules Kim and I'm currently the Chief Executive Officer at Scarlet Alliance. I mean, like many people, I started sex working when I was in university, you know, because it suited the flexibility of sex work, suited my full-time studies. It's work, you know, and it's like any other work. There's good days and bad days. It's not this kind of really kind of almost gothic image that people portray of, you know, like hunchback clients and, you know, kind of, you know, victimised, abused sex workers in cages. And it's certainly not the reality for the majority of sex workers.
There's a breakdown in a way around stigma and discrimination as people are starting to see us as real people. But there are other areas where stigma and discrimination is going up. So on the whole, nothing's changed apart from the details. If you got a job as a sex worker tonight, would the first thing you did tomorrow morning, would that be ring your mother and say, I got this great job as a sex worker? Most people don't. But if you got a great job in Macquarie Bank or wherever, you'd probably be so excited you'd tell everyone. Okay, why can't we tell everyone? Our jobs are really great jobs.
There are plenty of not great jobs in the world that people can get, and you know, people often make a choice, and lots of people choose to do sex work and lots of people don't choose to do sex work. Still, like when talking to my family, even though they know I'm a sex worker, they still, you know, sprout the same stuff that lots of people think that's really negative about sex workers.
Often people that are making statements about sex work haven't actually even spoken to a sex worker, if any. So it's based upon their presumptions and perceptions of sex work. Scarlet Alliance is the Australian Sex Workers Association. So we were formed in 1989 and we represent sex worker organisations and projects and individual sex workers throughout Australia. There's a lot of negative media around sex work, so it's very important for us to get sex worker voices out there and represent the real experiences of sex workers. Our organisation is entirely 100% led and staffed by sex workers, and that's really important part of our response, in that sex workers are the experts in our own lives, and you know, we are the best people to represent our own issues.
So I have three roles at Scarlet Alliance. I'm the administration manager, I'm the national training and assessment project coordinator, and then I'm also the elected trans sex worker representative. Not all sex workers might know about, you know, the issues that trans people face, and not all trans people know about the issues that sex workers face. One of the issues for trans people in Australia is that there's not as many workplace options for us as there are for cis women sex workers.
I used to be their male sex work representative for quite a long time. I got involved in gay rights, and then I realised there was another whole issue around sex worker rights. It's a difficult job, it's difficult emotionally, it's difficult mentally rather than physically. And for male sex workers especially, we work alone, independently, and there's a lot of isolation sometimes.
I think that's why it's so important for Scarlet Alliance and the work that we do, that we are sex workers speaking about our own experiences and speaking for ourselves. And that, I think, goes a long way to demystify and unpack the stereotypes around sex work. Sex workers have been discriminated against on the basis of our occupation, for housing, by banks. Certain banks might have laws that say that they have this morality clause where they won't provide loans to people engaging in criminal activity and classify sex work as such, even though it's not. We are in a fortunate situation at the moment where there's two very good bills of sex industry regulation before Parliament in South Australia, and if that's passed, it will be the first full decriminalisation of sex work, probably in the world. Sex workers have been fighting, advocating for decriminalisation for a very long time now. So hopefully good things to come.